like anybody with a heart,
right.
I spend my life teetering on the verge of tears.
Yes.
Because you can't possibly put yourself in that position, in their position, those mothers and fathers, those children, those 2.3 million, well, a bit less now, people living in Gaza, being bombarded by F-16s day and night, week after week after week. You can't, one cannot even begin to imagine what it must be like. 2005, I think, the show was sold out, but and I cancelled that show, having heard that, you know, Highcombe Park is built on a Palestinian graves and blah, and blah. But I came to some kind of internal compromise because I knew very little about what was going on in Palestine. And I moved the gig to a agricultural community where they grow chickpeas. I went back the next year and went on an extended tour. And we went all over the West Bank. And it was chilling beyond anything that I could ever have imagined to see back then in 2006, what was going on. And the absolute disdain. I remember thinking at the time, if they're like that to me, what must they be like to the Palestinians? And of course we know. And now, to bring it entirely up to date, we know exactly what they're like to the Palestinians because they are, as we speak, committing genocide in Gaza. It's quite clear to anyone with half a brain that they are committing genocide. I'm happy to say that almost the whole of the rest of the world is going, nada más, stop. No, don't ceasefire for 4 days. You must stop the killing. It has to stop. It clearly, this Zionist experiment in the Holy Land has now officially failed.